Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials or any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please do write me at contact@devopsschool.com. Thank you.
So guys, what is config map? First of all, what is a config map? And what is secret? So these two topics I'm going to talk about together. Okay, config map and secret. So guys, here, do you want to store data in Kubernetes cluster? This is I'm asking. Do you want to store the data in a Kubernetes cluster? So let me ask you one question to all of you. Is how do you store the data in Kubernetes cluster? Anyone? How do we store a data in a Kubernetes cluster? All of you? Let's just spend less two more hours, guys. I know that's Saturday and many of you are feeling lazy, but yeah, just two more hours and probably we'll finish this course. So yeah, where do we store the data in Kubernetes and how do we store it? Tell me.
In a persistent volume or outside? No. In a stateful container.
I'm saying in a cluster. I'm not saying in the volume. Volume is a separate topic. In a cluster, where do we store? Cluster stored. And how do we store it?
Key value pairs will be
correct. Yes, you got it. Yeah, etcd. Correct. Simple thing. So, do you want to store the data in a KRS cluster when I say, then do you want to store the data over there? Sometime what happens, guys? Sometime you want to store the data in a cluster itself and use during the in the pod. So what kind of data you want to store in the cluster? It can be anything. There's no as such list. You can have some certificate file you can copy and keep it. Some certificate file, some secret keys, some token, some password, some sort of information which you want to store in a cluster. Anything, I don't care. But you know that very well, someone explained it. It has to be stored in a key and value format because etcd is based on that concept only. So now the question was, what is a config map? So config map is one of the API. Secret, what is secret, is one of the API. But what exactly is doing? So both the APIs basically will help you to store the data in a Kubernetes cluster. Simple. Okay, in the same place which you have said just now. Etcd, and in the same format what you said just now, key and value format. So when you use the config map, okay, or secret, you will store the data in a cluster and then you can mount inside a pod and container. So you can attach to the pod and inside the container. How you do that? Anyways, you know that, but I'll show you still. But then you must be thinking, okay, why do we have a two API resources for it? Why don't we have one? So there is a difference here. Config map, this is not encoded. The data which you stored using config map, it's not encoded. But as when you use through the secret, the data is being encoded. Now, remember here, I am not saying it's encrypted. I'm saying encoded. There's a difference between encoded and encryption. So please mind it. So that way, that little bit of higher security, you get it. So rather than, let me talk about it. So here I open up a config map here. Okay. Now look at my screen, guys. I'm doing a demo, and again, same time you can see it also. So do we have a config map? First, let me see that. And I must tell you here, by now you know all the commands actually. So you know there is no commands which is now lying with me. All the commands, you know that. So here I have one config map, which is some cube hyphen root hyphen CA cert that I got it 47 hours ago. So if I see other namespace, so here you see, so this config map you get in every namespace actually. Now how, why do we get it in every namespace? That you need to find out. For time being, I can tell you, you know all the commands. There are few things you will find in like SA service account, you will find everywhere. Okay. Config map, you will find everywhere. Secret, you will find everywhere. See here, one of the secret is mine, by the way. And this one also, SVC, you will find here. This SV, so you can describe and get to know more about it. Okay, so you know all the questions for time being. I know that. So but for time being, let me show you the config map. So here, do you have a config map in a default namespace? I have a one, but that I'm not talking about it. Okay, it has a one data basically. So one data means one key, one value. Okay, this is the name of the config map. So here I'm creating a config map using this file. So this is the file, reverseproxy.conf is the file, and here I am creating a config map. So this is the content. I stored it. Now, how do we create a config map? The commands is been given. Look at this. Create config map, my config from the file. Guys, the understand this. This config map you can create from the file also, and from the environment variables also. There are many ways actually, but this is more easier. So go ahead with it. So I created a config map in default. Can we list out? See here, I got this. Here I have a one data. The key is here, this one, and the value is here. Can we see that? So I think I can see mine one. Describe what CM, right? And my config. And here you see this spelling mistake, by the way. And you see here, I can see this is the key. This is the one data. You can have many datas as well, but right now this is the one data. This is the key. And this is the value. All this is value. So guys, I got the config map. Any questions so far? How do you create a config map? This data is stored in the etcd. Any questions so far, all of you? Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Am I audible? Okay. So now next thing is, guys, pod. Now look at this. I think it's damn simple. What do you want? Pod from which image? This image. If you look at this here, that's important. Volume. Look at this here. Type is a config map. Name of the config map here you specify, and items, data items. Key, you have a reverse proxy, which is here I showed you, and the value, the path which you use means in the wherever you mount it inside, that this key will be renamed with this file. So this file will be created, and the value will be embedded in the file myconfo.conf. So now if you see that here, this is the volume, config volume, which you are mounting here inside this location. That means inside this location there'll be one file called myconfo.conf, and the content will be from this. Simple. So let's copy this file, clear the screen. VI, I want to store this file pod pod.yaml. Done. Kubectl create hyphen f pod4.yaml. I did it. Now if I see that, see here, I'm going inside it, and okay, container is still creating it. I'm inside a container right now. Look at it. Now, can we go and check here? See the file myconfo.conf, and this is the content. That's all. So did you understand, all of you guys? What is the config map? All of you? Hello?
Yes.
Guys, are you there? Okay. Now next one is secret. So now let me explain the secret. So guys, secret, there is only one difference is secret, you will encode it and store it. So now here what I'm doing right now, this is the secret I'm creating. Look at it, my screen. I'll explain it to you here. This is the secret I'm creating. Kind is equal to secret. All the command, you know that. Now here, secret has a key and value to data, key, value, key, value. Now you must be wondering, what is this value? I don't know. So basically this is the encoded value. How do you get it? Here it is. So if you see the encoded value, sorry, there's a spelling mistake. See here, this is the value. So this is the encoded value. You got it. Now if you store this one, you will see the encoded value. You won't see the content, which is a real content is admin and password, but you will see this one. So that way people will not be able to get it. So now what are you going to do after creating a secret like this? After that, again, you see pod volume here, my secret, the secret name is my secret here. And now inside this location, etc foo, if you go, then you will find a username file. Okay, username file. See here, username file and password file. And you will see the content where username is equal to admin and password. And decoded will be done by Kubernetes, so you don't have to worry about it, and password. So did you understand that here, all of you? Guys, did you understand this secret?
Yes.
Yeah,
so that's a difference between secret and config map. Many times where we use it, so when you want to do the some configurations of applications and you want to call it from the cluster itself, you can call through the secrets. Okay, now let's talk about the auto scaling. So here I have auto scaling also, HPA. Here it is. Look at my screen here. This is the one of the perfect example for auto scaling. You need to understand the first this code, and then I'll run this command. I think command, you know that way basically. So here you see here, there is a one deployment. Now deployment of this image, HPA example. You know what? This image has a certain advantages. So you will ask what advantages. So gradually what will happen? This image, whenever you run, this is from the Google image. Whenever you run this image, automatically their CPU will be increased automatically. Are you understanding this? Because here what we are doing, HPA, HPA means horizontal pod autoscaler. That means based on the CPU uses, your pod number of pods will grow. So here I need some traffic to be increased, but here I cannot increase the traffic. So what we have, this image, this container itself will automatically keep occupying more CPU. This is designed in that way. Are you understanding, all of you guys?
Yes.
So here we have a deployment. Now what is the deployment? I think you know that, but here what we are saying here is like the pod, whatever you are running, that should request the CPU 200 M. So that means each pod, which is a part of the deployment, each pod which is a part of the deployment, it should request for 200 M CPU. That is a maximum threshold we are setting up. That means if it is more than that, then it should not be asking more than 200 M. Okay, so we set the CPU threshold for the each pod actually. Okay, now what we are doing is we are creating a service. Remember I ask you to create a service through kubectl create service command and then kubectl expose command also, but this is the YAML file. What we are doing basically, you are doing the node port, target port, HTTP port, which will be taken from here, HTTP port here, okay, name port here 80, and some TCP port, and type is node. So basically you are creating a service of node port here. Okay, the port number is this one. Now what you are doing right now, you are creating HPA. HPA means when to scale up, when to scale down. Okay, so here you see this is the HPA code. So what you want, HPA horizontal pod scaler, but for which one? So for which deployment you want? So scale, target reference, deployment. Okay, this is the deployment I'm talking about. This is the, by the way, it's a V1 right now. You can use the V1 also. Okay, so deployment. Now what you are setting up, minimum replicas it should be 1, maximum replicas 10. That means in this range it should scale up and scale down. Now when it should scale up, whenever the target CPU utilization percentage is 50. Okay, that means whatever you are saying, this is the, what is the maximum utilization for each pod you set? 200 M. Out of 50, how much? 100 M. So the moment the pod is reaching to the 100 M, then you should keep growing this number of replicas to 1 to 2. Are you understanding this code, all of you guys? Hello. Hello.
Yes.
Yeah. So now what I'll do, I'll just show you the demo for this. So CD HPA. HPA. So guys, look at my screen. It's an important one. So here what I'm doing right now, this is the deployment I am creating. So YAML. Now kubectl, all the command you know that, so I don't have to repeat that again and again, same command deploy. So here there is some problem. So it's it should be app v1, so I'll just correct it. That got older versions, right? So it's app. App or apps, I forgot, by the way. Apps, I guess. It says it's validation missing field selector. There's some fields which is missing, maybe. Okay, I'll do one thing, I'll copy from of the this one official documents, because this code got little outdated, so with the older version. So again, in Kubernetes website also you will find one code which will work for you, so that's not a big task. So here I will just go and down it's not there the code is here, but it's too much of let me get some yeah so this is the better one. Okay, so let's deploy this one. Yeah, so look at this, here you are deploying again some PHP image, HP example, same image, but location is little different. So let's use this image, and here you have a service. So let's do one thing, I'll copy entire content, service will be created as well. Okay, and here deployment also. So VUI, done. Now what I'm going to do is kubectl apply and deploy, done. So deployment is done, service is also created. Now what I'm going to do is this is done, this is created. Now I'm going to create a auto scaling HPA. Now how can you do that? Through so HPA also, YAML also you can do that, and through the command line also you can do that. So here what we are doing through command line kubectl auto scale deployment, which deployment? PHP Apache, which is here. And if you look at this here, you set the some limits also. So the pod should maximum request for should request for 200 M, and the limit it should not go beyond 500 M. That's a limit. So here I am going to create, and here what you are doing, CPU percentage of the each pod, if it is more than 50% set, 50% set means more than 100 M, then it should go and starting from 1 to maximum 10. So here auto scaling done. See here, can we check now? Now automatically it will go up, and see here. So right now target unknown, because it will take some time to get you the reporting done. 1 to 10 replicas right now, 1 0 5 seconds. So over the period of time you will see that this is 0%, 50%. So over the period of time you'll see that and get going. So you can use for the HPA this code, and you can try. Did you understand that, all of you guys? Automatically it will increase that. You can create some traffic on the site using this command also. So I'm creating a traffic on the website. See, this is the traffic. Okay, so like that you will see that, and after some time if you do the get HPA, you will see the target and this that. So did you understand, all of you?
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the 399 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.